In this video, we're going to have a look at scenes in Home Assistant, what they are and how you can make the most out of them. Make sure you stick around, and if you like what you see, make sure you hit subscribe below so you don't miss out on future videos. Hi, I'm Will from Will Surridge Tech, and in this video we're going to be looking at scenes, different ways we can set them up and trigger them, or even automate them. Now if you stick around until the end, I'm going to show you how you can run effects on your Hue light bulbs in Node Red. So let's get going! First of all, what is a scene? Well, a scene is a way of capturing multiple states of multiple devices in one place. Do you find yourself, when you go to dinner, always having to turn the same lights off, the same lights on, and constantly playing the same music or turning the volume to the same level? Well, all of that can be captured in one single scene, so you just have to press one button and it all happens for you. There are two main ways of achieving this effect in Home Assistant. You either use the Home Assistant scene functionality, or you create an automation using the Home Assistant automation features or Node Red. Or you could use a combination of the two to create an ideal scene. Let's have a look at the pros and cons of each method. Using the scene function is a very easy way to create a simple scene. You just put your entities in, put the data that you want your entities to abide by, and that's it. The problem with the scene function is you can't do anything complicated. You can't put any delays in, for example, and you can't put any conditions in. So you might want some things to happen, but only if it's something else. For example, if you're watching a film, you might want the heating to come on, but only if the room is below 17 degrees. This is where automations come in. With automations, you can include conditions and timings. For example, your dining room curtains might only want to shut if it's dark outside. The beauty of an automation is you can include a scene in it. So you can create a scene that sets up your lighting state, and then use the automation to change the conditions for your curtains, for example. It's a great way to use both together to create the same effect. The first thing I recommend you do when you start out making scenes is to write them all down. This doesn't have to be anything fancy, but just writing down what you want to happen, any conditions you want, and then any settings you want each device to have is a really easy way to keep your workflow organized. It means you can make sure you're achieving everything you want to achieve with the right conditions at the right time. These are the scenes that I'm going to be using today as my demonstration. As you can see, most of my scenes are just using media players and lights, but you can use any entities that you have. And you can use any sensors you have as your conditions if you want. With the built-in scenes and automations features, you can either create them using a visual editor or in the YAML. If you create it using a visual editor, it will then appear in the YAML later if you want to go and edit it there. So let's start off creating the dinner scene in the visual scene editor. All we have to do is add all the entities that we want to control in our scene. This is really easy, and then we click on each entity and set it to what we want it to be. For example, turning the lights on to a certain color temperature or a certain color. Unfortunately, because of the way some things are integrated, for example, the Sonos, we can't have full functionality. For example, I can't actually select a correct playlist in this scene, so I've got to select the playlist in my app, and then it will transfer over. And once that's done, I can just save it. I also can't force the Sonoses to not be grouped at this point. That is a downside of using the scenes integration. Once we're happy, we click save. This will create a scene entity that we can then trigger directly, which is a great bonus of the scenes editor. If we want a bit more control, then we can use an automation. The main difference between a scene and an automation is an automation needs a trigger. This could be the time of the day, a specific sensor reaching a certain point, or just a manual button. That's not really a problem, because if we just want it to be a manual button, then we can create one using an input boolean. I'm going to do that now for the three scenes that I'm going to create today. This is very easy to do. We just go to our configuration file and add a new input boolean. As you can see, I've got mine referenced elsewhere, so we're going to go into that file and add some more input booleans. We give it a name, an icon, and a title. We're also going to want to set the initial to off. That means that if you restart Home Assistant, it won't turn on automatically. Otherwise, that would trigger all your scenes in one go, which isn't very good. Now we can create the automation. We're going to start off using the Automation Visual Editor. I don't use this myself, because I think there's much more capability in Node Red, but we'll give it a go. As I said, you start off with a trigger. this is going to be our input boolean going from off to on. We can then ignore the conditions and start adding all our entities. If you use device as the action type, then you can only set the brightness of the light. We want to have more control. We want to be able to control the color and the color temperature and other things potentially. So we're going to use the cool service type instead. In here, we can add the service data for all our brightnesses, our color temperatures and that kind of thing. It gives us much more flexibility. As you can see, you can also trigger a scene here. So maybe you might set up your light state in a separate scene that you can recall in multiple different automations. And then you recall that here with some other devices with other features instead. This is how you can combine both scenes and automations into one. For some reason, this automation isn't actually working. And because I don't actually need it to work, because I much prefer to use Node Red, we're just going to ignore that. But this does give us an excuse to give up on this method and move on to Node Red instead. As with normal automations, you can control scenes and devices in Node Red. But the added benefit of Node Red is palettes. You can download certain palettes for certain types of devices, which give you direct control of the device API. This means that you have much more precise control and more functionality. I have palettes for my Evo Home setup, my Hue lights, and my Sonos speakers. So let's start off by making the dinner scene. First of all, I'm going to label this scene so I know what the flow's for. Next up, we're going to set the trigger as the input boolean. What we're going to need to do is turn off the input boolean so it's ready for use next time. But I'm going to add a little delay so I can be sure that the scene has triggered before it turns off again. Otherwise, you wouldn't see that you've triggered the input boolean. Next up, we can start adding some entities. First, we're going to control the main lights. I have a dinner scene set up in my Hue app, so I can use one of the Hue nodes in the palette to control this and trigger it directly. Equally, if you had a scene set up in the normal scene section of Home Assistant, you could trigger that using a cool service. Or if you don't, you can just trigger each light individually using the cool service nodes. Once we're happy that the main light's done, we can control the other lights. I'm going to control these using a cool service node, entering the brightness and the color of each light. The great thing about this is you can add multiple entities to one cool service. So I'm going to control the left Kallax light and the right Kallax light in one node. This reduces the number of nodes you need and makes things a lot more streamlined and efficient. And it means you're sure that both lights are going to do the same thing. Now we can do the music. I'm going to use a selection of universal Sonos nodes from the Sonos palette to do this. I don't really understand how these work as they've recently updated the palette, but using some examples that they give you, it's quite simple to follow. What we want to do is make the kitchen and the dining room leave any groups they're in. We're going to pause the music in the kitchen. We're going to clear the queue in the dining room and then add a certain playlist as a new queue using the My Sonos node. And then we want to play that queue. We're also going to want to change the volume so it's nice and quiet. If that works, we can move on to the film scene. This is the same principle again. We have an input boolean and we turn it off after 10 seconds. We have a selection of cool service nodes for various lights and various devices. And we have a Hue node for the Hue lights. We also stop some Sonos music playing that might be distracting. Now we can move on to the heating. I'm going to have a condition in my heating that if the temperature is below 15 degrees, then I turn the heating on to 21 degrees. To do this, we're going to use a getState node to get the state of our climate, and then a conditional node to switch it so if it is above 15 degrees, it triggers the next node, and if it's not, then it doesn't. So in the next node, we're going to use a cool service for the climate and set it to 21 degrees. It's very simple and easy to follow using this method of Node Red. Lastly, we're going to have a cool service node to turn on the TV. We can link it up and test it out. If it works, then we can move on to any other scenes that we want to create. And we can just keep going. The possibilities of Node Red are endless. I said I'd show you how to run effects on your Hue light bulbs, so here we go. We're going to be using the Hue palette for this. We're going to need a trigger, which can just be an inject node, or whatever else you want to use, the Hue magic node, and a Hue bulb node. You set the bulb to the bulb that you want to trigger, link it all up, and then you can select the animation in the Hue magic node. For this example, I'm just going to use the fireplace as a demonstration, but there are plenty to choose from. For example, you could use the sunrise node and integrate it into your alarm sequence. So every morning your lights come on with the sunrise. Wouldn't that be a great little feature to have? If we link it up, we can test it out and see that our flickering is happening on our light bulb. And there we go. We've had a look at multiple ways of setting up and triggering different scenes. Make sure you hit subscribe below to find out more about my smart tech and how you can build yourself the ultimate smart home.